Hello everyone, welcome to UN College Digital Class. I am Manisha Manashwini Padhi, lecturer in the Department of MCOM in Finance and Control. I am covering your marketing portion. In my previous video lectures, I have already discussed a lot of things regarding marketing, marketing introduction, types of marketing, product mix, place mix, different marketing mix elements, and in my recent video lecture, I discussed about product decision and the types of product which are available in the market, which is specifically divided into two types, that is consumer goods and industrial goods. All these things I have discussed in my previous video lecture. In my today's video lecture, I am going to discuss about two important parts of a product, that is product line and product standardization. So let us go to the video and understand what is product line and what is product standardization. So product line is a group of related products manufactured by a single company. So obviously product line the meaning of product line is it is a group of related products. The product under the product line has a group of related products, line products. That means those products which are related to each other and which are manufactured by a single company. If we want to understand what is product line through an example, we can say that Horlicks is a company. So Horlicks offers different varieties of products like sugar-free Horlicks, Horlicks for junior kids, Horlicks for pregnant women, Horlicks for ladies, etc. Okay, so this is we can call a product line. So product line is a group of related products manufactured by a single company. So there is a single company which produces related products, which produces a group of related products, which is known as product line. So next point, that it is a group of products that are closely related to each other by function, customer group, market or price range. So the products available in a product line are closely related with each other in different criterias, like by the function, by customer group, by the market and by the price range. So they are closely related because they function in a similar way, are sold through the same consumer goods, are marketed through the same type of outlet or fall within the given price range. So we say that product line, the products in a product line are closely related because they function in a similar way, they are similar in their functioning, they are sold to the same consumer groups, they are marketed with the same type of outlet. The retail shop where the junior Horlicks will be sold, that only in that retail shop the elderly Horlicks will be sold, sugar-free Horlicks will be sold. Okay, so that is why product line is a group of related products which is manufactured by a single company. So what did we understood? Product line is a group of related products. There is a single company which prepares the product line. The products available in the product line are similar in nature, is made available to the same consumer group, and which is of similar range of prices. So if we talk about junior Horlicks, sugar-free Horlicks, Omen Horlicks, etc. So these three products are a product line of Horlicks. So these three are offered to the same consumer group, has a specific price range. There is no that much vast difference between the price ranges, and this is also available in all outlets. Product line of Horlicks is available in all outlets. Okay, so this is the basic meaning of product line, which is a group of related products. So here another example is given, that a cosmetic company, there is a cosmetic company which offers different kind of fashion products, creams, etc. Okay, so for example, a cosmetic company's makeup product line might include foundation, concealer, powder, blush, eyeliner, eyeshadow, mascara and lipstick products are closely related. Okay, so there is a company which is a cosmetic company. So the product line under the cosmetic company will include different kind of things which is related to makeup products. So these products are closely related to each other. That is why this is called a makeup product line. So this includes different kind of makeup products like foundation, concealer, powder, blush, eyeliner, eyeshadow, mascara, lipstick, etc. There are other products also. Okay, so So a product line is typically managed by a product line manager who may supervise several product managers who are responsible for individual products in the line. So for managing the product line, there is a specific manager called product line manager. So if that is a, if we take the example of that particular cosmetic company, so for the makeup product line, there will be a product line manager, a single person who will control, who will manage the whole makeup product line. So that manager will hire more product managers, several product managers who will manage the different products. The product foundation will be managed by the particular manager. The product which is concealer is managed by another product manager. Okay. So basically there is a particular product line manager who will manage the whole product line. And under the product line manager, there are other product managers who are responsible for individual products in the particular line. Because this is not essential, this is not possible that the product line manager can manage all the products. Okay, so there are different product manager who will responsible for individual products which is available in that product line. So the product line managers usually have the responsibility of determining whether the product line should expand or whether product should be removed from the line. So managing the product line lies with the product line manager. So product line manager usually identifies that which product is performing better and which product is not performing good in the market. So this is the duty, this is the responsibility of the product line manager. He will decide, he will determine that the product line should be expanded or the product should be removed. Because the product which is not performing well in the market, that should be removed from the line so that the loss of the company can be minimized. But if one product is making good in the market, one product is doing good, doing very good in the market, then that specific product line should be expanded so that it can get the company with more amount of profit. So all the responsibility lies with the product line manager. Next point, they will also analyze the effects of the product expansion or contraction on the profitability of other products in this line. So the manager cannot decide arbitrarily that the product line should be expanded or should be contracted. So the manager has to analyze the effects of the product expansion and contraction. The manager will analyze that if the product line is expanded, then what will be the consequences? And if the product line is contracted, then what will be the consequences? And according to that, the decision will be taken. So the duty of the manager is to analyze, and the decision will be taken by the owners of that particular company. So next point is, one company can offer more than one product line. So obviously there is no that compulsion that one company can only offer one product line. So one company can also offer more than one product line. So we can say that there is a company called Tata. So Tata offers different varieties of services, different categories of services, which is for unrelated product. So we cannot say that this is for a product line. Okay. So Tata does not follow product line because one company can offer more than one product line. So if we consider that, Tata, Tata is providing salt, Tata is providing steel materials, Tata is providing car facilities, etc. So this proves this point that one company can offer more than one product line. So here there are certain features of the product line. If we have understood what is product line, then this is very easy to find out the features of the product line. So first one is that product line consists of closely related items. So obviously we can say that a product line consists of a related items which is individually related to each other. So there is difference in the price of the item. So obviously in a product line, the products available in the product line differ in their price, but the price is not that much remarkable. Okay. Third one, they are sold to the same consumer group. Next point, they can be manufactured using same technology. So obviously the technology which is used in producing Junior Horlicks is as same as the technology used in producing the sugar-free Horlicks. There will be some kind of difference there, but not a huge amount of difference. Okay. So last one, The product items are distributed through the same distribution channels. Okay, so the same distribution channel like wholesaler, retailer, etc. So different products available in the product line will also get distributed through the same distribution channels. So this is what product line is. Product line is a group of products which is related to each other. So the price of different products available in the product line are not significantly different. The outlets where the products will be sold will be the same. We don't need to find out another market for selling our different products. So the consumer groups are also same. But product line is very important in understanding the marketing research. So once one product get successful in the market, so the marketer will think of expanding the product line with adding more and more products. So this is the whole concept of product line. Next, we will discuss the product standardization. So what is the meaning of standardization? Standardization means there will be a specific standard of a product, specific quality of a product which will be followed, which will be maintained by the company. Basically, this product standardization is telling about brand. Okay, so obviously brand is a symbol of or sign of quality. So the brand, the quality of the brand should be maintained by the company so that the consumer base will be remaining with that particular product. So let us understand what is product standardization. So standardization is the process of setting generally uniform characteristics for a particular good or service. So obviously standardization means we have to set a specific characteristic, specific ceiling that the quality will not be compromised at any cost. Okay. So it refers to a framework of agreements to which all relevant parties in an industry or organization must adhere to ensure that all processes associated with the creation of a good or performance of a service are performed with the set guidelines. So if we are talking about standardization, so a specific quality of standard, specific ceiling of standard will be maintained, specific standard of goods will be maintained. So at any cost, the company, the branded company cannot sacrifice its quality. That is why we have to pay more while purchasing the branded products or availing the branded services. Okay. So this product standardization is a framework. There is a specific set guidelines for the standards. So the product at the time of introduction in the market will not be conferred as a brand, but after creating its stability in the market, it will be converted into a brand. So let us understand the definition. So according to E.E. Clark, standardization includes the establishment of standard, the sorting and grading of products to conform to this standard. So standardization does not only include the quality of the product, it also includes different associated services with the product like its branding, labeling, packaging, etc. Okay, so everything should be up to the standard so that the standard of a product will be maintained. So this is the basic meaning of the definition. So whenever we are saying that there should be a standard which needs to be maintained, so there are specific criteria on which the standards have to be maintained. So standards are fixed in the terms of basic weight and measures, size, shape and dimension, chemical or technical properties, product performance and quantity of units of sale. So these are the specific criteria, specific terms on which the standards are fixed. So the product maintaining the standard should have a specific weight. There should not be any kind of adulteration going on for that particular product. Okay. So product should perform good. The brand I was using 10 years ago will be the same when I'll be using after 10 years. So the quality of a brand will not differ. This is then only we can say that the product is standardized and the product is branded. Product standardization is an efficient method to reduce costs and increase quality. So obviously, if again and again we are focusing on the quality, again and again same person, same company is doing the work producing the branded things, then the product, the person or the company will become specialized in producing that particular product. So this will obviously reduce cost, and this will also increase the quality, increase the efficiency of that particular company. So by minimizing the differences in products, companies are able to rapidly increase production, streamline distribution, decrease raw material costs, and reinforce product branding. So let us understand this through an example. So for example, many fast food franchises have detailed processes documented to make sure that a burger is prepared in the same manner regardless of which chain in its a franchise a customer visits. So we can talk of McDonald's, we can talk of KFC, Domino's, etc. So they have a specific standard, they have a specific process documented, means it is in written that this is the way the burger should be prepared, this is the way a chicken should be prepared. So whenever who is taking the franchise of those particular companies, McDonald's, Domino's, KFC, etc. So those companies, those franchisees has to follow the documented processes in order to prepare the particular product. So this is the standard which is maintained by the fast food franchises. So this is what standardization means. Whatever the situation may be, wherever the place may be, the product, the quality of the product, the standard of the product will not be sacrificed. So this is what standardization means. Here we have to maintain a specific standard, we have to maintain the specific quality of a product so that the product can be established in the market, the product can retain its place in the market as a brand, and the customers purchasing the product of that particular company will not get disheartened, will not get dissatisfied, because satisfying consumer is the most important thing. If we want to purchase branded product or qualitative product, we should be prepared to pay more for that. Okay, so let us understand what is the importance of standardization. We will understand this by three parts, that is the importance of standardization from customer's viewpoint, from seller's viewpoint, and the society's viewpoint. So let us understand what is importance of standardization. So from customer's viewpoint, first importance or first advantage is buying facility. So the customers can buy standardized products easily. The customers need to inspect all the goods which are not standardized or graded. So if the products are not standardized, then the customers has to inspect all the goods. So the customers can buy standardized goods without looking, inspecting, or by looking sample or from description. So obviously the customers don't have to inspect all the products if it is using the branded products. Okay, so buying facility gets easier. Next point is using facility. So using method, instruction, and composition of standardized goods are given. This makes the consumers feel easy to use. Necessary repair facility is also provided for some goods. So using facility is also given on the product, also printed on the product. So this is easier for the consumer to use. So it makes the consumer feel easy to use the particular product. Next point is our protection. So the customers don't have to suffer cheating from seller with standardized goods are given. They can remain protected from adulteration and exploitation from the seller. So if the product is standardized like Kellogg's, like the products provided by Kellogg's, products provided by Nestle. So these are branded products. So these products will remain protected from the adulteration which is made by the seller. Next point is fair price. So obviously if we are purchasing branded products or standardized products, we will be prepared to pay the particular price. So since quality, measure, size of the product are known, the customers can buy goods with fair price after studying the market price. So if I want to purchase a Audi or a Mercedes, I will do the market research and I will study the market price. Then I will go to a shop and purchase the car. So fair pricing strategy is maintained in product standardization. Last point under the customer's viewpoint is that market information. So the customers can get short description and information about standardized goods through advertisements, other buyers, and different sources. So if it is a standardized product or branded product, so this is very easier to get to collect the market information for the particular product. So customers will get short description, information, advertisements, other buyers, colleagues, friends, family, etc. So so obtaining market information for the products will also get easier. So these are the advantages or important from the customer's viewpoint. Next, we will discuss the advantages or importance of standardization from seller's point of view. Under that, first point is selling facility. So the goods which are standardized become very easy for sellers to sell. No inspection is needed to sell such goods. They can be sold out only by looking sample or description. So obviously this becomes easier for the seller to find out to purchase the goods without any kind of inspection, because the branded products has a specific quality and it will get sold obviously. Okay, selling facility is enjoyed by the sellers. Next point is loan facility. So as the standardized goods have ready market and fluctuation of price may be exceptional, banks easily accept such goods as security to provide loans. So if I want to take loan for doing a business where I am going to sell standardized products or branded products, so banks will easily accept to provide me loans for that particular products. Third point is increase in goodwill. So as standardized products have certain quality, quantity and price, so goodwill of the sellers of such goods increases. They can earn more profit from selling high quality goods. So obviously if a store is selling only luxurious cars like Audi, Mercedes, etc., so this will increase the goodwill of that particular store, that the customer's base will also rise, because they are selling the branded products and the seller can earn more profit by selling those standardized or branded products. Next point is wider market. Obviously, determining the standard of products and grading them is the foundation of an organized, open and wider market. So if I am doing business for standardized product or branded product, I have a greater scope that I can enter into a wider market. There will be a less competition and my sales portion will also increase. So these are the advantages or importance of product standardization from seller's point of view. Next, there are the some advantages or importance of product standardization from society's point of view. First one is mass production. So the society can get standard quality goods at lower price from mass production of the same standard and same grade goods. So obviously if we are purchasing a huge amount of things together, we will save something and we will have to pay low price for purchasing those products, which is called economies of scale. Next point is market information. So obviously this was also present in the point of customer's point of view. This is also present here, that is society's point of view. Market information. So as the producers and trade associations publish information and messages about standardized goods, society knows everything about the quality, standards, etc. So if this is a branded product, so the different trade associations like FSSAI, RBI, etc. publish information regarding the particular standardized or branded product. So this becomes very easier for the society to know about the quality, quantity, size, standard, shape, performance, longevity, etc. of the particular product. So collecting market information gets easier for the society. Next point is protection. So there does not remain any risk for the society to be cheated by the sellers in buying standardized goods. So obviously if the product is standardized, we will be able to collect market information from the product. We will be able to know what is the quality, quantity, size, shape, longevity, performance, etc. of the product. So the society will remain protective from fraudulent activities which is made by the sellers. If we found something wrong in the product, we can complain with the company. Okay, so we won't get cheated from the sellers. So here this is the point, which is protection. So So there does not remain any risk for the society to be cheated by the sellers in buying standardized goods. So every buyer knows the quality, standard and price of the goods. So this is not easy to cheat the buyer or cheat the society. So the last point is employment creation. So when demand for standardized goods increases, the firm should intensify the process of production and distribution. For doing so, more manpower is needed. So standardization creates more employment, because if we sell standardized product, my customer base will increase. And in order to fulfill the demand of my customers, I have to produce more products, I have to manufacture more products. So in order to manufacture more products, I need more manpower in my factory. So this will obviously create employment in the society. So from society's point of view, there are various importance of standardization, that is mass production, market information, protection and employment creation. So we understood that from seller's point of view, the advantages or importance are selling facility, loan facility, increase in goodwill and wider market. Similarly, from customer's point of view, there are also different advantages or importance, that is buying facility, using facility, protection, fair price and market information. So I hope you have understood product line and product standardization. This is very important from your exam's point of view. I hope you have understood it. If you didn't get something, you can ask me in the comment box and I will clear your doubts. Thank you so much for watching.